Madam Speaker, we do have a crisis in this country. The crisis consists of a shortage of workers as our birth rate goes down, as our aging goes up, we have fewer and fewer workers. And since economists tell us that the number of workers is what produces prosperity, this is a crisis for the country. Fortuitously, we have a situation where we have several million people in this country who are Americans, who were born, who have raised, lived almost their entire lives in America, who, as was mentioned before, find out they weren't born in this country only when they apply for a driver's license when they're 18 years old. They are a resource for this country, and they ought to be legalized, which is what this bill does, so that we can utilize their talents properly and remain in a rule of law. Madam Speaker, organizations, associations, and industry leaders from across the political spectrum support passage of H.R. 6, the American Dream and Promise Act of 2021. They include among them United We Dream, Service Employees International Union, AFL-CIO, and these unions do not fear competition. They know it is good. The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops, United States Chamber of Commerce, Apple, and the National Education Association. After closing the books on 4 years of disastrous and inhumane immigration policies, today we begin a new chapter, one based on compassion, reason, and the fundamental values we hold dear as Americans. Passage of H.R. 6 is long overdue. Today's vote will dictate the future of millions of dreamers and recipients of TPS and DED and will greatly help the economy of this country. I urge my colleagues to vote in support of the Dream and Promise Act of 2021, and I yield back the balance of my time.
Pursuant to House Resolution